What's going on, YouTube? This is your boy Clutch. I'm bringing you a Battlefield Hardline gameplay. We're playing Conquest Small on Dust Bowl. Had a pretty good game, but that's not why we're here. Why we're here is the new Black Ops 3 trailer was released today, April the 9th. This video will probably come out on April the 10th, somewhere around that. But I just wanted to let y'all know, guys, I'm back. Got some new quality content coming, so a lot of stuff going on in my personal life, so couldn't really cut a couple videos. It's been a long struggle for me, but we'll get there. I'm tired. My room, sorry man, it's a disaster. But you know, I wanted to talk about the trailer a little bit. There was a leak on Reddit, and some YouTubers had put it on their channel. There was a list, and what that list was available, or what that list was entailing, was what Black Ops 3 was going to implement in the game. And I took some points of what I wanted to talk about, and this is just my opinion. My opinion doesn't matter. I'm a small YouTube channel. I'm trying to bring quality content to you guys, and we'll see where it goes from there. But let me change something on the screen. But what I wanted to talk about was this list, and the list that people said that was in, that were gonna be in Black Ops 3. Number one, current gen only. I like that aspect. I don't like how they're gonna make a game for Xbox 360, then render it for the next gen. I mean, hell, we're next gen consoles now, so let's build a game specifically for next gen. You know, another rumor was that the campaign was supposed to look amazing, better than Advanced Warfare. True, Sledgehammer Games makes a phenomenal campaign. You know, with that being said, I don't play the campaign. If you're here on my channel, you're probably here for multiplayer. I'm not the greatest player in the world. I'm not in Optic. I'm not in Envy. I'm just a regular Joe Smo that plays video games, and I enjoy them. I enjoy bringing commentary to you guys about the game, news, things like that. I'm not going to sit here and do, you know, oh, here's a head glitch spot so we can play game battles 2v2 and this and that. Yes, I will be bringing game battles if I can find a decent partner, but I'm not a fanboy, and I'm not going to be on the nuts of certain developers. It's just not going to happen. So with that being said, the campaign's supposed to look amazing. I don't play the campaign. I don't give a shit about it. Again, another rumor for the campaign, it was supposed to be an open world. You know, open world, but still linear, to where you have to... You're taking your guy, whatever point you got to go to, whatever hostage, whatever you're trying to do, you are taking, you know, it's a linear route, but it's still going to be supposed to be open world. You know, that's a pretty good idea in the long run. You know, again, campaign doesn't mean nothing to me. So the next rumor, which I think is a real, real good one, is the custom map editor for the private lobby. You know, the things that Halo 3 did, and that was a long time ago. So, you know, you could build this, build that, and I like that. I think that it would be fun for private lobbies to go in, and you could practice for certain situations if you were playing in game battles. You know, you could hone your skills, so to speak, for Call of Duty. And there's nothing wrong with that. I think it would be a good implement for the Call of Duty series. And the next one, you know, we've seen in Call of Duties before, you know, and it's a good decision to do it. I think that it makes Call of Duty great, and that's the dynamic weather and the elements on the map, for every single map, not just pick and choose the maps. It's going to be for all the maps, and I think that's a good deal. You know, in Battlefield that I'm playing now, you know, and I'm not a Battlefield player, I'm a COD player, but I wanted something that would that I could play and have fun with. And I think Battlefield is pretty fun. I mean, I think the spawns are a little fucked up, but that's for another video. Let's get back to Black Ops 3. You know, the elements of the weather and the structure of the buildings falling when grenades hit them or light machine guns tearing them up, or, you know, I like that. It makes the game exciting. I don't think that there was one rumor about a 16 versus 16 or a 32 versus 32. I don't think that would be good in COD unless you did it on a private match where you could do that with, like, say you build a map and you wanted 32 versus 32 and you invited 32 of your friends in. I think that would be cool. I would try it out, bring some gameplay of that. But, you know, let's get into the meat and potatoes. The meat and potatoes of this video is David Vonderhaar has a chance to change Call of Duty, give it a, you know, Call of Duty's in a cardiac arrest. David Vonderhaar could give it CPR and bring it back to life. With this next rumor, if it's true, he's just going to kill COD. COD can't last with three games being shit. I don't see it. And that is the jetpacks and or exoskeleton suits being able to move and do this and that. You know, I heard different YouTubers say it. I want my troops on the ground. I want boots on the ground. That's why I play Call of Duty. It is a war game. I understand that we're trying to go different directions with the mindset of different ideas of what it could be in the future. Nah, man, it's still in the future. 10 years from now, our troops are going to be on the ground. True, we're going to have, you know, artillery, we're going to have bombs, but our troops will not be in Afghanistan flying around with a goddamn jetpack. Vonderhaar, what are you doing? You're not listening to the public. You know, you have a guy, or Sledgehammer made a game in Advanced Warfare with a guy shooting around the goddamn map like a mosquito. Really? A mosquito. This is not the game Bugs. This is Call of Duty. We want our troops on the ground. We want balanced guns. We want great map flow. We want to be able to dictate as a team how we control that map. Vonderhaar, why can't you listen to us? You're too busy with your devs in a room drinking Corona with your feet kicked up, dreaming of off-the-wall bullshit that is not going to happen. I don't give a shit. 50 years from now, our troops will not be flying around Iraq with a goddamn jetpack on. It's just not going to happen. Bring it back to reality. Bring it back to Black Ops 2. Black Ops 1. Those were great Call of Duties, man. The score streaks were fun. The kill streaks were fun. You know, let's implement some of the things that we missed and make a great game with boots on the ground. Come on, Vonderhaar, you have a chance to do something that Sledgehammer Games could not, and that is save Call of Duty. Call of Duty goes suck. Advanced Warfare, suck. Straight garbage. Vonderhaar, if you do not listen to the public, you will fail. I don't think Call of Duty could last this year with a shitty game. I really don't. I honestly feel that Vonderhaar has a chance to make something special to bring the fans back into the Call of Duty series. Will he do it? I don't know. If these rumors hold true of the exo suits or the jetpacks, I think it's going to ruin COD unless they do something. I don't want them in there, period. But if they are, Vonderhaar, why don't you use them as a kill streak or a score streak? Instead of going up, down, side to side, boost jumping every goddamn where like a mother flipping mosquito, why not use it as a score streak? If you a low score streak, say 2 or 3 kills and an assist, you get this, and your ability to not go up and not go down, but shoot side to side, dodge, and maybe go back for 1 or 2 bursts. If you're playing, like, say, a domination, you're on the B flag and they're nading it, it would be a perfect opportunity to dodge behind cover. That's fine. I think people can live with that. But not every single burst and this and that. I just don't think that Call of Duty could last another minute with exosuits in the game like it is in Advanced Warfare. Let's go on to one that I do thoroughly enjoy one of these rumors, and that's the Pick 13. The Pick 13 is supposedly returning. I think that they did a great job on that. I think Vondahar, you know, with your class setups, you could do several different things. You know, if you wanted to run SMG or AR or LMG, you know, sniper, there was different things that you could do. You know, you weren't set to specific class setups. And I got some videos coming up on Hardline that you know, my beef with that, because I'm not a Battlefield guy. I'm a Call of Duty player. But I love the Pick 13, and I'm glad Vondahar's putting it back. You know, but the things that he's doing right do not outweigh the things that he's doing wrong. And I think that is a big muck-up for this community, because this community's dying. Let's just be real. I mean, you got little kids sitting in a corner with a goddamn gun behind a bush with a ghillie suit on waiting for you to run past, and boom, you get shot in the back three or four times with a OP, you know, insta-melt pistol. I mean, come on. You know, you have all these YouTubers that are out here that, oh my God, this is the best Call of Duty ever. No, it's not. Let's just be real. Let's be real. And that's one thing that there's not a lot of real people out there anymore. I'm 100. I'm going to keep it 100. Advanced Warfare sucked. Call of Duty Ghost sucked. Let's just put it there. People have broke the game. People have, you know, snapped the game. It wasn't fun to play. You know, it kept me interested for a little bit, but it did not hold me like any other Call of Duty has. And you know, Black Ops 1, great. Black Ops 2, great. Modern Warfare 3, it was mediocre. But Black Ops 2 was the epitome of what a Call of Duty should be. Let's go back to that, Vaughn. Why don't we go back and figure out what we did wrong, bring better guns, better weapon balancing sights, things like that. Great maps, because you know, if you watch YouTube, you know who Legend of Thunder is. Thunder talks about it all the time. The flow of the map is what makes the game, or what makes that particular map, that whatever game type you're playing. Map flow is phenomenal, but map flow is key to how that particular map plays. I haven't seen really a good map since Black Ops 2, and he's right. Raid on Black Ops 2 is great. The other point that Thunder hit on one of his last videos was the simple fact that, like Nuketown, how can you remake Nuketown? Because it's going to play different. It's going to play different because there's different weapons and there's different perks, there's different this in the game. It's a total, complete different map whenever you remake it vice the original. You know, and you're still going to have the kids running around with snipers and things like that, but there's things that we can fix, and there's things that we can move on to the future of Call of Duty. But if Vondahar gets this one wrong in 2015 with Black Ops 3, Call of Duty will be dead. There's so many games coming out from Rainbow Six, which I saw some alpha gameplay the other day, and it looks phenomenal. Saving hostages in a building, in a house, in an airplane looks pretty sick. That's something that you can do with your friends, and there's different tactics that you can use to do to save whatever hostage that you're going to save. Then you have Tom Clancy, The Division, coming out. Phenomenal game. I mean, you got Batman coming out. There's a bunch of good games that I think people will leave Call of Duty and go play because Vondahar failed. He has the chance of a lifetime to listen to the public. He has a chance of a lifetime to listen to what we have to say, and I hope he does that. You know, I think at the end of the day, Vondahar should listen to us. We should have some sort of beta. You know, with a beta, we can actually figure out, you know, what's wrong with the game, what's this, what's that. And for that, I understand from the beta aspect. I don't understand why Call of Duty doesn't do a beta, and I have a feeling that it's because it comes out every 3 years, 3 year cycle, or it comes out every year, but with a different developer. You know, there's three developers building COD, and it comes out every year on that cycle, and they just don't want to put a beta out there. And I think that a beta would cause, or not cause, but it would be phenomenal for the community. They're alpha testing a game right now, the Black Ops 3 game. We're going to have gameplay footage on April the 26th, I believe. You know, and why can't they put some sort of beta to see what we think? Give feedback on the game that they are making and make minute adjustments on what we say. I think that the fanboys out there, yeah, there's a lot of them, but I think the general public don't want the exosuits, don't want the jetpacks. I think that they're going to ruin the COD. Listen to these people. Listen to the public and stop making a game for yourself. You know, and I said this before. I don't mean make a game just for you, because ultimately you are thinking, oh, this might be cool. The community might like this. I understand this, whatever, yada, yada, yada. I don't think you understand us. I don't think you understand the Call of Duty players. I think you are focused more on competitive COD, which you did in Black Ops 2, but you merged it well. You know, I think that you take out skill-based matchmaking for team deathmatch and kill confirmed and thing like that. You know, and then you have a whole separate avenue if people want to go out there and get in a bunch of sweaty lobbies with a bunch of tryhards with their control freaks and their scuff controllers and go ham. You know, I enjoy those types of games every now and then, but not every goddamn lobby. You know, I'm tired of, there's sometimes I get off work, I just want to come home, play a little COD, do a commentary, and be done. You know, I'm not out here trick-shotting 150 kills a game. No, I don't understand that. But, you know, Vondahar, listen to us. The developers, listen to the public. Guys, I appreciate you stopping by my channel. A lot more to come. I'll catch you on the flip side. Be looking out for more Battlefield Hardline videos, more Call of Duty updates, or Black Ops 3 updates, and I'll catch you on the flip. Peace.